Basically, what we are going to do today is aggressive 6-0 defense and transformation from 6-0 to 4-2, 3-3 and 5-1 defense. I will show you the way how I'm working. I'm working for a long period of time, the way that makes some result, and the way, according to my experience, it's the good. I'm now specialist for the female, but I was working half of my career with the men team too, so it doesn't matter one or the other. The basic thing is always the same. If you're going to play defense, you have to play with all your heart. If you, my way of thinking about the handball is very simple. Defense, you play with heart, with the brain in the attack. But all the time, you have to give 100%. Less than this is not good enough. For me, in handball exists what I call Holy Trinity. I can, I want, and I'm able to. First, I can, it's technical knowledge. If you have technical skills, I can do it. Second one, bonus part of field, I want, mental part. Without this, you don't have anything. Third part, I'm able to do it, is physical fitness. One without the other. If you have only two of these things, you're average. Even in the worst part, if you don't have the middle part, don't you have this wish, this want to explain and to make yourself better from day to day. I'm happy that I need only 20, 30 years of my life to become. Last year I was voted the best creation coach of the year. And they give me all kinds of medals after 30 years. That means they are waiting for me to say goodbye. But it doesn't matter. What we are going to do today, I hope that you will enjoy, that you will see something that is useful for you. What is useful, take with you. What doesn't fit you, take it away. And just, again, as a player, do the best that you can. Okay? Let's start. We will start little by little. Basic things here in a half of court, passing in with a couple with the ball, running any way you can, run backwards, run forward, left, couple, right. On my whistle, the players that have a ball go one, but easy, one on one with one player, then without the player without the ball, the third player without the ball, and so on. When I whistle the next time, continue with passes. Okay, let's go. I'm just throwing the ball left, right, whatever I want. The ball can drop only once. You can catch the ball here to me. Go. We are passing the ball. Still, you are working in couples only. When I whistle, put the ball on the floor. Turn around from the ball. You are defense player. Behind you, your couple is the back player. He has to pass it at the ball. You do it. Stop him anywhere you are. First action is looking like this. You're looking at the ball and try to stop him. When they will be the second one, then you look at him and try to stop him. Okay, continue. Let's go.
Two groups of six. Each group we need four balls. Four players with the balls make a square. Square of 3 meters. Task is very simple. Player in attack. Make change of direction and make double pass with all of them. That's local, that's enough. Your job is to prevent the player pass the ball and follow him all the way. In full speed, we're doing this for 15 seconds, then we change. Go! You beat him, keep the ball!
Right back. Normal. Don't go too far away. Normal penetrating, pass the ball. That means I'm right back down there as well. I'm going and penetrating, pass the ball. After I pass the ball, I'm running to the opposite post. Down there. Diagonal. Change of direction very fast. Touch the post. Fast change of direction. Come here to the cone. Go between the cone. The lateral movement. And after the cone, 3 meters sprint. That's it. At the end of the line. Once and then, okay?
Pass the ball right here, in the middle. Right here, in the middle. Go right there or there. Go!
Thank you.
We're doing the same, but again, always like to take one defense in this part.
Again, the most important thing when you are in defense is agility, changing the positions all the time. You're changing direction, you're changing the speed. You never go the same pattern, just like this. You have to go there. This is why we are doing this. Go straight, change direction, make a sprint, go to a faster break. Second part, what is important in defense. Always we play defense, we are training faster break at the same time.
Now, same exercise. Go down there, you are going down there, go out, here deep, go back, and that's sprint.
Working simultaneously, at the same time,
you give the ball to the left hand, you give to the right, I'm attacking, you are going up, okay? After this, both of us, I'm giving the ball back here, you give both ball there, you too, change direction, go to the line, you go down there, and 7 meter, same, from here, no, what time we're out of here, we're not going.
In the same time, you two attack players. You change places, same. After pass, cross.
Pass over. After this, you two from defense, run to the center. As a faster break, two from attack, they're coming to defense. Okay?
Go! Yeah. Go! Defense, sprint! Next, two in attack, go! Okay. Go! Sprint! Next two, let's go! Change! Change! Sprint! Go, next two! Throw a slana! I'm a sprint! Let's go! Fast, let's go!
Groups of three, each one the ball.
Each one. Every player. One of the most important things in playing defense is that you should go simultaneously. Simultaneously. It cannot happen that two of them are going this way and the other one is going that way. You have to be almost in this position, as I said, open the hand, you move all the time. Now what we are going to do is very simple. The player in the middle is making the dictate. You are running forward, backward, left and right as you like.
Okay.
Just don't go diagonal. Straight, left or right. You have to follow them. The same way he is going, you are going, then you are going. Okay? When I whistle, we will continue this with some exercise of technique. Very simple. When I whistle, when you get the ball from this side, you will get the ball in your left. Somehow. At the beginning, we'll do the same. Just make passes between you and him,
yeah.
And you and him until the center.
Okay.
Nothing else.
Okay.
It's a ball. Move down there.
Now you can see some mistakes
because one of the most important things in defense movement
if it should be simultaneous. It cannot happen that one is going one way, the other is going the other way, or two of us, we are like this, very close, the other one is 5 feet from us. We have always to be at the same distance. And this is what we want to achieve here, by making these movements, but the distance should always be the same. And if I'm going on the one side, it cannot happen that my player goes on the opposite side. This is the basic rule of defense. Ti ide za njim napad. Ako on je na trašku, ti napadaš on je napad. Nakon toga, izmjenjujete dodavanja do centra, ali krećete se bočno. Ti se krećete bočno, izmjenju se pasno. Nima krećete se na drugu stranu. Pa padne se. Ajmo, krećete. Go!
Hey, play.
Watch, no! See, now we have a bit of a problem. This is the basic thing once again. Move to the left. Because now, this player is doing that. The other one sees it. And then move all the time. Speed of it. This is why you're doing this one for the initial level all the time. Because of this close step, move all the time. And this is basically defense and handling. So steps go out, make a foul, go back very fast. Let's go one more time.
If I'm going against the playmaker, I'll make a feint, you're dead. There's no way he will stop you. You have to be very fast, and you should always keep the distance between the players. Always. All the time. Now we are going to move the goal to the start with some basic exercise, one-on-one with blocks. Just to continue this.
How many you need?
One block is enough.
You can change the direction, only the left hand and stay down there. And you can go to the middle, same to shoot. Change the position. Immediately after this, take your ball, make a pass to the other player here. You are shooting from the middle, you are going to make a double look.
Double look.
Immediately after this, make a pass going down there, 1-1. Again, double move, and then 1-1. Okay? Move it. Go! One in the middle, one left, one right. Just open yourself, spread yourself. Go with the ball. It doesn't matter, you'll change your time. Go with the ball. Left the ball. Now we start here. We start in the middle. Give the ball to the playmaker. Go here, and you're going 1-1. This is it. After the shoot. Okay, move on this side. Get the ball to the playmaker. double look.
One on one in the middle, from the other position. And the three of them are changing places all the time.
Last one, if you cannot catch it, okay, then make more. Or if there is a tick that number two and number five are very aggressive and pull them in the middle where you have two tall guys, you can do it. But basically what I want to do, once again I'm talking about now playing with my players, the girls that are 170, we cannot block anymore. We have to be aggressive, we have to make a foul, we have to push them to make some kind of mistakes or to shoot from any other position. Here you can see the basic problem on the handle. Player goes out, and then without this feeling over here, it's running back. You lose the coordination. I'm going left or right, just like I want. Or wait for him and then start to dance with the player attack. Make the first move, make the first move, go to the first set, make a foul. Make a foul, make a foul. Don't wait here to react, you react first. All the time, be aggressive. Okay. Go here with two defense players here. Any two defense players here, sure. Oh, no. There, one defense player down there. Go one of you down there, defense player.
This area here, play two against two. Two against two. After this, immediately, when you are the back player, you are going down there and become a defense player. From here, after two, you are going to have, you are going to this position, and this will be the other player.
Understand?
Yes.
They're playing two against two here. After this, the back player on that side.
You'll be jumping against two on this side, and you're playing two against two. After the shoot, back from here, goes down there, become defense player. Once you are number three or four, comes to number two. Then at the end, full speed.
Good. Well done. Stop it. Go down there. Play. Go, follow yourself. Go dancing. Yes. I want you to go out. One out. Go. Here, in the middle, field, one field in the middle and two defense players.
Here one defense player, here one defense player. We have 20 minutes to play again. Field ball from the wing. Ball from the wing. Say here.
One-on-one. Ball down there from the wing. One-on-one. One here. Then one against one there. Then here two against two. Then after this, four against four. You three with the field against them. Once again, 6-0 doesn't mean you are sending 6-0. Look where you are. From this position, me as a player, if he is for instance, he can kill you by scoring, by going 1-1, he should go out. First position in 6-0 defense from all men team. It's on 7 meters. At least 7, even if not deeper. 7.5. And make a foul. Don't stand at 6. You're too shallow here. Everybody will kill you. Go and make a foul all the time. Let's go. 1-1, let's go. 1-1. Back here. 1-1 down there, let's go.
Always to be close, like you're playing some kind of instrument. Always close, this distance.
Make it open your hand, open it, like this.
I'm older. Play. Attack one. Good. 4 against 4. Give the ball. Let's go. Again, nobody did make a foul here. Come to the playmaker. Two of you, you are catching the pivot. Both of you.
Now we will continue with 3 against 3, 4 against 4, a little bit incorporated some movement. Let us say faster break on the half court. We're not using the older board because tomorrow we are going to run far too much. Well, tomorrow we have retreat in defense after you miss the ball. So there is a lot of running. We're doing this at the end. We just put them in defense 6 against 6 and let's see this what. Mr. Zanotti and I prefer to do so-called Korean defense 6-0. That means the number 2 is going out at the same time, number 4 can be here, just 4-2 defense at one time. Because when you play 6-0 defense, basically 6-0 is never 6-0. Only at the beginning of the game. Any moment when somebody's out, it's 5-1. And from this one, you can make 4-2, you can make 3-3, as you like, depends on position of field. You need to have, of course, good players, number 25, they are good in defense, 1 against 1. Clever guy in the middle, they catch the ball, then they'll be okay. We'll have 3 defense players here, okay? And the other group, imagine one group, we have 2 groups of 3 players. 2 on one side, 1 on the other side, in the corner. And the third group will be 2 of them, 1 left, 1 right. The task is, we'll put all the balls in the middle. Darko, you will help me, please.
Okay.
With all the balls in the middle. When I whistle, the groups down there in the corner, they're running fast, like you're running fast. Okay? First guy will get the ball, make a cross, you do this one, you make the other cross, and then you continue to play here 3 against 3. 3 against 3, after the shoot, guys from defense, just make a sprint to the center, like you're in fast break, and go back, you from the tech, stay here. Okay? But when you come here, please, after you make this double cross here in the center, and when you come here, don't finish the action in 5 seconds. Put the ball, organize the attack, make some movements, make crossing, make double cross, make this with the opposite cross behind the back, that playmaker is going behind the back and so on. Let us play handball. Enjoy, make something what is unusual. Don't always do the same thing. No, I know it's that easy. But just develop your imagination. That's all. Okay, so three in defense. Now it's a little difficult, but we'll just make it with two groups, two players. They can take rest. I need in each group four players, and in each group should be one two. Four of you, this group, four. You are in defense, you two left, two right, down there.
We are doing the same. Triple cross, pivot, take the first ball, and then go to the line. We are playing four against four, but what we want to play, the rest is defense. Handball, not possible, not tolerable, aggressive. Nobody can come inside that league. Inside that is the minefield. Dead man.
The way that defense is winning, what I want to say. You're playing, we make the 14, two teams to play on this side, four against four, three against three, two are playing downside. It's semi-final. You are in attack. If you score the goal, you go in defense. Only in defense you are collecting the points. You make a foul, they miss. First time coming to five is the winner. Then we change, we play finals, and then we're playing for the third position. It's extremely good for the fighting spirit of the team. And believe me, they're fighting so hard that it is incredible. It's what I like to do a lot, and to put. Now, day by day, meaning we have less and less players here. Until then, we'll say how much we'll have. But now, we'll do it only with three groups of three, only here. Let us say, until two come first against five, to increase this fighting spirit, what they're doing. And then, what we said, six against six, and finish it because they're going to die. Okay. We're doing it this way. We are making three teams of three. Playing three against three here on this road. But the rule is defense is winning. What does it mean? If you are in defense, first thing will be defense, okay?
Okay.
And if you stop the attack, normal way, cut the ball, intercept the ball, or they miss the goal, you will get the point.
Okay.
First time come to 5 points, the winner. But if you get the goal, when you score the goal, you are going in defense. That means that's giving you the chance to get the points. Only in defense you are getting the points. Attack means
only if you score.
Of course, you don't score, you're again in the attack all the time. But
go!
Unfortunately, we have only 10 players. We cannot play five. If anybody of you would like, that's what we are supposed to need to do at the end. This defense.
Yeah.
6-0. We're going to 5-1, 4-2. I would be glad down there with nice after Ronaldo finishes his theoretical. That Johnny and I, we can explain you and tell you the ideas how we are doing this and what we are doing. Unfortunately, we cannot do it on the field because every step one player is dead more and more. But I hope that during this session you can see my philosophy of defense. The philosophy is that we have to combine defense with possible goal attack. In the first break, you in the warming up exercise, you can prepare yourself for these technical movements. Philosophy that aggressivity is all. Let us push the players in attack to shoot from 10 meters. Let us push the players from some positions that are not normal, they are awkward. Let us make them the mistakes and then run to the faster break. Diagonal position goal. Once again, if you want to play aggressive defense, everything is diagonal position of the player. You cannot do it the opposite way. Of course, you have to pick your players, you have to know exactly what each player can do. In Scandinavian way of defense 6-0, they said that number 2 and number 5, they should be the best one-on-one. They should be the best one-on-one, so nobody can beat them. They said that the position number 1 and number 6, they are the motors. Why? They are moving all defense one side to another. Here, during the game, if you see, one time we have the split defense in two pieces. Because two of the players stay and catch the field down there and the ball is in the opposite side. We have to be compact all the time, all the time, all the time. And aggressive. And most of all, this is very simple. Once again, handball is very simple. You can make it complicated, so complicated that nobody will understand. The people with the highest IQ in the world, they will not understand what you are doing on the field if you want to do it. Try to make it simple, try to make it very clear to the players, and try, just like Dragan Rajivan said, you will succeed in defense when the players start to like playing defense. This will be your biggest success. When they will start to like to play defense. When they will start to understand that this is what gives them the results. Because in my way of thinking, playing in defense is not only important because you are not getting the goal and you will score the goal after break. There's one more thing. Good playing in defense gives you freedom in attack. This is the same. If you get here every time, no. When you attack, you will attack. What if I miss now? I'm losing it. But if you know it here, you will stop them. Anytime. I will run back, I will stop them in the first place. I will stop them. Then in attack, I can play free. I can do all my potential. So I will be not afraid. Because again, basically, when you are not free, when you are free, each player has his angle. And the goalkeepers know it. This player, when he, this is his angle, usually in position when he's going down there. I have very simple explanation. Luka Modric against Denmark. Left down, it's his angle. This is how he was shooting again. He was tired, exhausted. So let us just give them the freedom by playing this. Let them give a lot of exercises that will not so good. As you see, this is the mental thing. They need a lot of power, they need a lot of hard work to do like this. But I'm doing this again with the girls. And they are doing, of course there are a little bit more of them, but they're doing in the higher speed than this was, much higher speed than this was. And then even the men's team, coach of one team in the first league, I said, look, I cannot do it with one player, what you're doing now. But this is not something that you will do one training in a month or one training in a week or even a year. This is something that you should do constantly. This is because they are always the same thing. They are asking, you know, what is more important, attack or defense? And every of us has our own philosophy, of course. But the best thing is that handball, it's a mix of all the things. It's a ring. And this is the beauty of handball, that one is mixed with the other. The defense is mixed with the transition. Position is mixed with the faster break. Then when you lift the ball, it's mixed with the fit in defense. And this gives us the chance to develop the players all the way. as you know, all of you, that handball is the only game that is totally developed every muscle in the human body. Every, not only legs like in football and only upper part, but every brain, all the time. So it is not important. In my philosophy, I don't measure the players on centimeters and kilos. I measure them if they know how to play handball or not. Do they have a heart or not? Because for me, this is the strongest muscle in the human body. Not the gluteus, but this one. If you have this and you have connection with your brain, then you are going to be a player. Just like I told you, whole Trinity, all together. Thank you very much. You have a question? That's it.
Thank you very much for your hard work. I hope that you get some ideas what I was like from you to do it, that handball cannot be played if you're not full of full heart. If you're playing with 50%, it doesn't exist. You cannot love somebody 50%. You know, I love you only 50%, not the other, so I don't care. I love you only if you make good meals. If you don't make, I don't like anything. So you have to love the game. Basic thing, you have to love the game. If you love the game, you will love all the parts of the game. And extremely important, it's to love, not to hate, but to love to play in defense. I told you, it will give you freedom in attack. Let's go.
Scandal 4! Oh.